waiting for the front, but I don't think they know it. Straight to the depths of hell, that's where them cowards going. Well, all you steal, damn nigga, holler when you see me. And let these devils off, but if they finally freed me, I got a caravan of niggas every time we ride. Hitting motherfuckers up when we pass by. Until I die, little life of a boss player. Cause even when I'm hot, fuck with me and get close later. The future's in my eyes. Cause all I want is cash and things. I vibe double O, bands pumping flashy brains. Bitches pursue me like a dream. Been known to disappear before your eyes. It's like a dope beam. It seems my main thing was to be major. Pay the game sharper than the motherfucking razor blade. Save money, bring bitches. Bitches bring lies. One nigga's getting jealous and motherfuckers die. Depend on me like the first and 15. They might hold me for a second, but they won't get me. We got four niggas and low riders and Steve ass screaming thug like. Every time they pass, all eyes on me. Live the life of a thug nigga until I dare die. Live the life of a boss play. All eyes on me. All eyes on me. Live the life of a thug nigga until I dare die. Live the life of a boss player, cause even getting hot. Hey, come on, nigga, pop. So much trouble in the world, nigga. Ain't nobody feel your pain. The world's changing every day, time's moving fast. My girl said I need a race, how long will she last? I'm caught between my woman and my pistol and my chips. Triple B, knocks and smokers on with so I'm gonna dip. I'm lost in the land with no plan, living life flawless. Crime boss, contraband, let me toss this. Mediocre's got a lot of nerve, let my bucket swerve. I'm taking off from the curb. The nervousness, neglect, make me pack a tech. Devoted to serving this, my wet and paid checks. Like a kite satellite, nigga, I'm forever ballin'. It ain't right, parasites, triggers, and fleas crawling. Suck a duck and get busted, no emotion. My devotion is out of my business, nigga, keep on coasting. Where you going? I've been there, came back, it's lonely, homie. Steady flowing against the grain, nigga, still don't know me. There's a lot of money in this rap shit, this crap shit. It ain't funny, niggas don't even know how to act shit. What can I do, what can I say, is there another way? Listen, shit all day, 24 parlay. My little homie G, can't you see I'm Busta Free? Niggas can't stand me, all eyes on me.
Live the life as a thug, nigga, until the day I die. Live the life as a boss play, all eyes on me. All eyes on me. Live the life as a thug, nigga, until the day I die. Live the life as a boss play, all eyes on me.
The fans is watching, niggas plotting and getting. Will I survive, will I die? Come on, let's picture the possibility, giving me trouble. Lawyers making a grip, I told the judge I was raised wrong. And that's why I blame shit, was hyper as a kid. Old as a teenager, on my mobile calling big shots. On a scene major, packing hundreds in my drawers. Fuck the law, bitches I fuck with a passion. I'm living rough and raw, catching cases at a fast rate. Balling in the fast lane, hustle till the morning. Never stop until the cash came. Live my life as a thug, nigga, until the day I die. Live my life as a pro. Players, cause even getting hot, these niggas got me tossing shit. I put the top down, now it's time to floss my shit. Keep your head up, nigga, make these motherfuckers suffer. Up in the bins, burning rubber. The money is mandatory, the hoes is for the stress. This criminal lifestyle, he put with the bulletproof vest. Make sure your eyes is on the meal ticket. Get your money, motherfucker, let's get rich and real. Kick it, all eyes on me.
Live the life as a thug, nigga, until the day I die. Live the life as a boss play.
All eyes on me. All eyes on me.
Live the life as a thug, nigga, until the day I die. Live the life as a boss play.
All eyes on me. All eyes on me.
Pay attention, my niggas.
Pay attention, my niggas. What's happening, fellas?
Nigga woke up in this
morning. Hope y'all having a good day.
And be like, ping,
ping. Like, share, subscribe. Follow me on Instagram, Michael Edwards.
I got busted so much from these watching, nigga. You know, live my life as a thug, nigga.
Subscribe to RBG Hebrew 2.
All eyes on me.
Subscribe to RBG Hebrew 4.
It's like what they think. I'm walking around with some keys in my pocket or something.
We'll do the rest of them later.
They think I'm going back to jail. They really on that door. Live my life as a thug, nigga, till the day I die. I know y'all watching.
I know y'all.
I know y'all got me in the scope.
Till the day I die.
I know y'all know this is thug life, baby. Y'all got me on the surveillance.
All eyes on me.
But I'm knowing.
Yes, I'm knowing. So how y'all doing, family? It's good to see all of y'all in the building today. Well, I guess everybody sees the title. I'm pretty sure. Mr. Lee, what's happening? Long time, yeah, brother. Been moving around, diversifying my portfolio, family. Yeah, been had to do some different maneuvers, bro. Good to see you back here. Okay. But yeah, it's amazing. And it's about to get ugly, you know. RBG Farrell, what's happening? Piece of black power. Good to see you here. And let's make the distinction now. This RBG Farrell that we're talking about is not the Farrell that we're about to drag down the motherfucking street. Not him. We're talking about Squeaky. That's what we should call this nigga. Squeaky. We'll call him Squeaky, and we'll call this nigga here Sleepy. Look, y'all seen this shit? Damn, Seti. Squeaky and Sleepy. What we call Seti? Sleepy or Droopy? Seti should be Droopy and Sleepy, family. Y'all know where this shit come from? This is the motherfucking bus station. In North Carolina, this nigga sitting up here nodding off. Nodding off, man. Yeah, man. And this fool here is the Negro that called young Pharaoh King Pharaoh. An old sleepy elder called this young fool ass nigga his king. He's sitting there sleeping. You know what this remind me of? I watched a documentary the other day, and it was about fentanyl. Y'all know what fentanyl is? Fentanyl is this shit they putting in all your cocaine and your heroin. Mm-hmm. Amongst other poisons. And they changed the effects of it. Niggas off cocaine, falling asleep. See that? That's the face of fentanyl. I'm booked, bitch. He booked. You must have been overbooked, my nigga. Mm-hmm. I know they watching. I'm knowing. We gonna get it started in just a second, family. Like, share, and subscribe, because it's gonna be crazy. Mm-hmm. And y'all did know this nigga here. We gonna call him Sleepy and Pharaoh Squeaky. But Sleepy got his channel taken off the air. Did y'all know that? Damn. When it rains, it pours. Try to tell them. Like, share, and subscribe. We're going to dig into it in about 2 minutes.
Roll up in the club. All eyes on me. All eyes on me. You know what? I bet you got it twisted, you don't know who to trust. So many player hating niggas tryna sound like us. Say they ready for the fuck, but I don't think they know it. Straight to the depths of hell, it's where them cowards going. Well, are you still down, nigga? Holler when you see me. And let these devils be soft, but if they finally freed me. I got a caravan of niggas every time we ride. Hitting motherfuckers up when we pass by. Until I die, live the life of a boss player. Cause even when I'm hot, fuck with me and be close later. The future's in my eyes. Cause all I want is cash and things. I'm 5 double O, then something. Flashy brains, bitches pursue me like a dream. Been known to disappear before your eyes, just like a dope thing. It seems my main thing was to be major. Pay the game sharper than the motherfucking razor blade. Save money, bring bitches, bitches bring lies. One nigga's getting jealous and motherfuckers die. Depend on me like the first and 15. They might hold me for a second, fucking fuck won't get me. We got four niggas and low riders and ski masks screaming thug like every time they pass. All eyes on me.
Sleepy and Squeaky, I'm telling you, my nigga, y'all be going to sit your motherfucking ass down. Oh, yeah. And it ain't just be my opinion. I'm going to leave the show some of your fans. Uh-huh. I got some amazing shit to show y'all.
So much trouble in the world, nigga. Ain't nobody feel your pain. The world's changing every day. Time's moving fast. My girl said I need a race. How long will she last? I'm caught between my woman and my pistol and my chips. Triple B, nonsense, movers, long whistle and the dip. I'm lost in the land with no plan. Living life flawless. Crime boss, contraband, let me toss this. Mediocre's got a lot of nerves. Let my bucket swerve. I
I'm taking off from the curb. The nervousness, neglect, make me pack a check. Devoted to serving this Moet and paychecks. Like a kite satellite, nigga, I'm forever ballin'. It ain't right, parasites, triggers, and fleas crawling. Suck a duck and get busted, no emotion. My devotion is out of my business, nigga, keep on coasting. Where you going? I've been there, came back, it's lonely, homie. Steady flowing against the grain, nigga, still don't know me. It's a lot of the money in this rap shit, this crap shit. It ain't funny, niggas don't even know how to act shit. What can I do? What can I say? Is there another way? Listen shit all day, 24 parlay. My little homie G, can't you see I'm Busta Free? Niggas can't stand me, all eyes on me.
Hit a life as a dub, nigga, until the day I die. Hit a life as a boss play, all eyes on me. All eyes on me. Live the life of the thug, nigga, until the day I die. Live the life of the boss play. All eyes on me.
The fans is watching, niggas plotting and getting. Will I survive? Will I die? Come on, let's picture the possibility, giving me charge. Lawyers making a grip. I told the judge I was way smart, and that's why I blame shit. Was hyper as a kid, old as a teenager. On my mobile, calling big shots. On a team major, packing hundreds in my drawers. Fuck the law, bitches. I fuck with a passion. I'm living rough and raw. Catching cases at a fast rate, balling in the fast lane. Hustle till the morning, never stop until the cash came. Live my life as a thug, nigga, until the day I die. Live my life as a boss. Cause even getting hot, these niggas got me tossing shit. I put the top down, now it's time to floss my shit. Keep your head up, nigga, make these motherfuckers suffer. Up in the bins, burning rubber. The money is mandatory, the hoes is for the strap. Cause criminal lights
down. If you love the truth, you gonna love this. I'm telling you, like, share, subscribe. Let's get rich and real, kick it, all eyes on me. Crypto God, what you say? I'm fucked up. All eyes on me. What you on? I hope you ain't on that shit Fetty on, that fentanyl. This nigga don't even make his cocaine no more. He just snort straight fentanyl, man. Oh, man. How many bags of Gucci do Fetty got? If you look at any picture of him up close, count the rings, my niggas. Those rings are bags. And that shit symbolized stress, foolishness, and I mean just a ignorant nigga. I told you, this boy said, Young Pharaoh is not Young Pharaoh no more. Young Pharaoh is King Pharaoh. Nigga, why you ain't say nice suit? Shit. Goddamn. But I got some incredible shit for y'all. And it's going to be real memorable, family. How memorable is it going to be? Well, I guarantee you, after this show, some of you niggas going to go buy some ginseng and shit to help your memory. Because I'm going to point out to you that many of you have literally forgotten how bad you've been robbed and raped and scammed and shit. Because the community is enamored with certain brothers that they have a hate for. But they look over the scammers right in their front pocket. Let's talk about it. Umar Johnson, Brother Sarnetta, Brother Polite, and now Brother Elijah Muhammad, Malcolm X, Minister Farrakhan, and Marcus Garvey. If y'all don't believe me, check the video before this one, I think on RBG Hebrew 2. I was addressing him and showing the young nigga how he incriminated himself. But that ain't nothing. This shit, what I'm about to tell you, is a trip. Now, I want you to jog y'all's memory just for a second, family. I want to jog your memory. And I know a lot of y'all don't remember this shit. But most of you will definitely be like, you know what? The fuck? When you get out of prison on a felony and you come out on parole, there are many, many, many rights that you've lost. Even a parolee, not just a convict. When you come out on parole, your signing of parole and your time that you have already served is literally your resume to the community saying that I'm guilty. I've served my time. They slapped me on the wrist or they punched me in the jaw, one of the two, and now I'm here, right? That's common sense. But obviously what is not common sense is a felon on parole coming to you all, and telling you, hey, I want to build a daycare center for your children. You black people. And all that sounds sweet and nice and great, huh? I said, let's put him on the scale with Dr. Umar. Man, Dr. Umar was just attacked. Went to court, couldn't take his credentials, couldn't do nothing but smear the brother. And he's still working for black people. That's honorable, Dr. Umar. But on the other side of the scale is a young man, like I began to say here, that says to you, hey, I want to keep your children. I want to provide daycare services. I want to build daycare centers. But let's not forget that this motherfucker here is a jailbird, fresh off the pen, on parole at this time. First question, let me pose to you. How many of you all allow your children, your babies, daycare age, to be kept by a motherfucker on parole? How many of you allow a person that you don't even fucking know to tell you, I know I'm on parole and I'm an ex-con, but give me some money so I can build a daycare center? Oh yeah, Pharaoh, it's going to get worse than this, doctor. It gets worse. Because the implied fuckery is not the rub. R.B.G. Pharaoh, I said, the implied fuckery, the shit that went over the people's head at first, is not the real fucker. I said, this bitch nigga is a real scammer, and I'm going to show you. He took advantage of people that were misinformed. Like I said, most people don't know that you can't do that. Fucking parole, and now you're going to jump out here and build a daycare? And be the founder of and the director of a daycare? Watch these facts, R.B.G. Farrell. Watch this shit, yo. After he asked for a specific amount, 10K, 10 racks, 10,000, that's not $20. That's a good bit of motherfucking money. That's a good bit of money that can be spread around through the community. Advertising services, appreciating people like my brother Sarnetta. The brother asked for $15,000 to appreciate the community, the real teachers, not these fake niggas. Watch this. 10 fucking racks. Y'all, not all of you all, but y'all know who you are that are watching. And just like Pop said, I know you watching, I'm knowing. But y'all, not the intelligent, not those that have a high intelligence quotient, but y'all that were so ill-informed that would let a man come to you, and I'm telling you, it all goes downhill from right here. Watch this shit, family. I'm a felon, on parole, come to you, you don't know me. Most of you don't have no clue of what I was convicted of as a parolee and a felon. I come to you and tell you, I want to build daycare for your kids. Never mind that I'm on a fucking video talking about those are UFOs and we're looking out the goddamn balcony and that's an interstate. We can clearly see that. Not to mention that. Not to mention the fact that on the other side of the scale is Dr. Umar Johnson, who obviously won't give up his work for black people. Won't give up. Even in the face of persecution, won't give up. Watch this shit, family. this brother did a campaign for the 10 grand for your money. He made a GoFundMe for it. He did several videos referencing the GoFundMe, soliciting donations. One more time, three times, soliciting donations. He's a felon on parole to build a daycare for your babies. He does all of this, the campaign, the GoFundMe, the videos, the Facebook posts, and you can find it still on Facebook because this silly son of a bitch was too dumb, too bad of a scammer to go take the shit off of the Facebook. You can even find, let me tell you, Young Pharaoh Allah, Sandra Bland, on Facebook. When you go on there, you can find the GoFundMe account and the campaign ended. But guess what else? Guess what else you'll find? You'll find that motherfucking video nowhere on the internet. I bet you was doing some goddamn backtracking and hustling, bro. Some computer work to get all of that goddamn shit off the internet. Because there is more people that know about this shit than me. I'm not the only intelligent person in the world. Watch this shit, Pharaoh. RBG Pharaoh. Not fuck Pharaoh. The GoFundMe, the Facebook campaign, the YouTube campaign, the fucking lie that he just told you, and I just spent all that time to let you know how much of a lie that is. He gets your $10,000 at minimum because I remember him saying thank you. God damn, nigga. I swear to God. Some of these bitches need pumpkin heads for real. Watch this, family. He destroyed all of the evidence. Or he thought. Bad criminals always do that shit. You break in somebody's house and you off that fentanyl like SETI. And you can't concentrate and can't focus on the objective. And you leave a fucking fingerprints every motherfucking way you go. That's what you did, YP. Oh, yes, you did. You left the motherfucking reference to the GoFundMe up there. You left the header on the motherfucking advertisement up there. You left your contact with your fans asking you about the motherfucking daycare or the money. We about to show it. Just y'all get you some motherfucking popcorn and get the kids out the room. Now, this stupid son of a bitch done painted itself into a corner. Because, like I tell y'all before, the universe, the great power of the ages, and all of our ancestors desire that all of us love each other and walk together. And love sometimes includes chastisement, application of the law inside the community. I want to see what y'all do with this shit after this stream. How many of you all that's chasing the so-called scammers, but these so-called scammers refuse to even fucking lead the community? But niggas like this attacks elders. Louis Farrakhan is an elder that has contributed so much to the black community. You would never, listen to me, you would never catch Farrakhan sleep in the Greyhound bus station like this. Nodding off on fentanyl. I said you'll never catch Farrakhan in no motherfucking bus station. Excuse me. You'll find him in no motherfucking bus station with no security. Man, somebody could have just probably took your goddamn shoes off, nigga, and everything. Yes, they attacked Malcolm X. Let's tell you one of the things they said about Malcolm X. Before we show you this fucked up shit. The Negro said, and this I quote, he said that Malcolm X was killed, his killing, one of the things that led up to that was Malcolm X disrespecting the parents of the children in the movement that were going to prison, right? This is what this bastard said. He said he got records and shit of Malcolm hanging up the phone on parents when they call them concerned about their children. And I'm saying, as much research as I've done on Malcolm, I ain't never seen and heard no motherfucking shit that corroborates that. And I ask you, where'd this nigga get that information from? The same information, rat hole that you probably got the alien mummy, remember? Shout out to YK the Truth. Remember the alien mummy he tried to push off in the Amara Squad, the little debate there? An alien mummy, a mummy alien. Nigga ain't look up no research, he just Googled. Google and then puke on you guys. He disrespected Malcolm. He disrespected Marcus Garvey. I have the radio transmission of that on Blog Talk Radio. This nigga lost his motherfucking mind when I put the video up talking about I clipped it and all of this shit and what he was going to do if I didn't take the video down. Well, what you going to do this time, clown ass nigga? I had respect and mercy on you last time. The video's up, dog. You gonna bring your ass to California? Don't fall asleep on the way. Disrespects Malcolm, Minister Farrakhan, Elijah Muhammad, Marcus Garvey. RBG Farrow says, I can't respect him. Nor said he. I remember all about Marcus Garvey. See? I don't lie, y'all. This brother here just said it. You remember. Watch this. And then, today, I'm telling you, boy, when it rain, it pour, and when the motherfucking chickens come home to roost, if you extra wicked, buzzards and crows and motherfucking... This boy got buzzards and chickens coming home to roost. He puts up, and this is March 2nd, right? Peace, peace, family. That's why I call him Squeaky. Peace, peace, family. GoFundMe is giving me difficulty. From here on out, please send all donations to my PayPal email, ypattorney@gmail.com. Why is he talking to you like that about an attorney? Before we get to the ultimate fuckery, I got to tell you what made this nigga jump out the window last time. The preface, the video that I'm telling y'all to go look at. Black Wall Street. That's why I called him Squeaky. This boy here sound like he don't have a separation between his nostrils in the back. Like he been snorting that motherfucking shit since he got out of prison. Yeah, that happens. When you're young, too young, and you're doing drugs, it fucks up your body and you mutate a lot. Family said, do the voice again. Peace, peace, family. Peace, peace, family. The nigga spitting and everything. Slobbering. Got an overbite. God damn. So this one right here, this reference. I'll show it to you. Y'all think I'm lying. Y'all take this shit in this whole video, screenshot this shit and run this shit all down. And come. Look here. This is his thing for March 2nd, right? That's the GoFundMe. You see it says YP Attorney, right? That was the scam after the daycare scam that I'm going to show y'all about. This nigga was trying to get money, and he did. This is goddamn. This nigga's a masterful liar. A master of manipulation, family. This brother here was convicted of a crime. One of them was the gun charge, right? I put the video out and the song that he did because he was so motherfucking stupid. He was so goddamn stupid to rap about the case in his song. This nigga said, I hit the fence and threw the Glock. Same motherfucking case, family, that he got convicted on. He's admitting that they was right. Shit, we know they was right because you're on parole. You admitted it. And you probably admitted a lot of other shit while you was signing them motherfucking papers in that goddamn room that first 48 room. Mm-hmm. And so he asks y'all for money after he's a parolee and he threatened to stab the air out of YK the Truth's chest on the air. He's a felon and ain't supposed to be associated with nobody pulling no guns or knives, but yet stupid ass Sleepy Seti is on the camera pulling the gun out on camera like he gonna shoot through the motherfucking screen. Y'all don't remember that shit. Some of y'all don't remember that. Threatens Dr. Ma'at's son. Say he was gonna throw him out the damn window, family. But no conviction. How not? Because he had a good ass lawyer. What kind of lawyer? A Jewish lawyer. How do I know that? Because I know the person that got him the motherfucking lawyer. Am I gonna tell the name? No. I am persecnate. It gets worse. And so he got money for y'all to buy him a lawyer on a current case. And he told y'all the money was to get his record expunged and to get a felony conviction rubbed off of his record. Now, again, ain't nobody stupid. If you've been and lived anywhere and you had any kind of real experience, man, you go to prison, felony, and you get paroled. That don't come off your record, dickhead, unless you're somebody like George Soros or something. Maybe you are, because there are niggas that come in here dropped off by the hidden hand. Ask Israel Doctrine. He's got a few in his pocket. But my dude, your case was, you were convicted. And you got money on the guise of you getting off on that, but you put it on your attorney. Then when you found out that was fucked up and people knew you was lying, when I put that video out and you spazzed out and you called yourself threatening me. But my nigga, I'm not you. You can't threaten me. I wish you would in my face, not over the internet. Yes, Roy Bay. What's happening, my brother? Good to see you in here, Roy Bay. Yeah, man. This nigga here. Y'all paid for donations for his lawyers on a fraudulent claim and on a current claim. He ran them all together and then split the shit after the money came in. But watch this one. Gets fucked up more fucked up. Remember, I told you, the daycare money, 10 grand, he begged y'all for, and y'all gave, not all of y'all, just the niggas that's looking at me and mad right now. I'm about to show you the screenshots. Y'all get your motherfucking cameras and devices ready, get the screenshots. I'm going to read this for you. Now, being that I told you that he went on and destroyed all of the videos, tried to backtrack, and left fingerprints everywhere. Watch this. These are his fans that he's going to lie to on Facebook about $10,000 caring for children. And he's a motherfucking felon. Watch this shit. And then after I read it, I'm going to show you this one. Then I'm going to read the next one. I'm going to show you the next one. After I read it, I'm going to show you the next one. So y'all can have this. And so you can have it too, Pharaoh. So you go back and fucking mop up, my nigga. Tahuti Pora says, what are some of the lesson plans for these days, for these daycares? Excuse me. What are some of the lesson plans for these daycares? This is a brother that obviously, like I said, don't know that parolees can't fucking do that. You can't be a director of a daycare center. You can't be a nigga coming out here asking for money for a daycare center and you're a parolee. You're a felon. See, it's an example of everything I'm telling you. This brother here didn't know that. This is why he's asking these questions. What are some of the lesson plans for this daycare? Brothers Keeper, what's happening, Rock? What's happening, Rock Prophet? Shalom to you, man. We tearing this, dragging this nigga down the street, man. dragging this clown ass nigga down the street. Peace and black power to you, Rod. Check this out. Tahuti Parah says, indeed, brother. Tahuti Parah says, what are some of the lesson plans for these daycares? I propose that some of the lesson plans consist of self-knowledge as well as African history and melanin science. This guy here must have been fucking drunk. How are you teaching science to a child at daycare age? This nigga don't understand. This guy here don't even understand reality. And this is some of the people. Pineal glands calcified. Brains maggot. Maggot brain. Bad diet. Niggas don't listen and shit. Can't comprehend. Enamored men worship. I said, this brother here is asking him, where's the lesson plan for daycare age children on melanin science and African history? How about if he was able to do that, just teach the kids how to speak at daycare age, the ass Tahuti. Excuse me, brother. And who's this in the chat? Let me see. Oya Ma'at, shalom, sister. Shalom, Dr. Ma'at. This is long overdue. Glad the brothers are stepping up and dealing with this. Ma'at. Family, we gonna pour lava on this nigga's back this time. Excuse me for the nigga, but we gonna pour lava on homie's back. So dude says here, he is that misinformed. Not only that Pharaoh is disqualified by being a felon and a parolee from being a director of a daycare and a financier. But watch this. This brother here says, what's the lesson plans? African science and melanin science, daycare, age children. Let's go to the next comment. Bria Cole. Y'all get your screenshot devices ready because I'm going to give you this one. And I'm going to give you the next one and the next one. Bria Cole says, will this be internet based or strictly in New York? I guess I'm asking because I'd like to know how this is going to help my children in our community. Are we going to have to move? Or will my children and I have access to these programs where we are? I said, did y'all hear that shit? Number one, this is a mother. But I got to tell the truth. This is an ignorant mother. This is a young, vulnerable mother. And I'm telling you, this is who these bitch ass niggas seek out. The young, the ignorant, the uninformed, and the vulnerable. Preferably women. This poor sister says, will this be internet based? A daycare. God damn, you gonna move from your state to where he is. You don't know this nigga. You don't even know that he been in prison and on parole. And you're talking about internet based. Are we gonna have to move? Or will my children? Will my children and I have access to these programs where we are? And watch this one, family. This is the motherfucker that's gonna trip y'all the fuck out. I said this woman is a mother. Green as hell. Don't understand. This nigga is playing y'all. Got you hooked up to a goddamn bit like a mule. Watch his response, family. I plan on opening daycares in every state. If you think I'm lying, sit there and read this shit. Let me put it on widescreen, goddammit. Hold up. Turn this bitch to the side for you. You can see this goddamn lie unfolded. See Tahuti's comment up at the top? See her comment, Bria. And look at this bitch ass nigga lying to this people. Where he say he gonna build the motherfuckers at, Dr. Ma'at? In every state. Y'all need more time to get that? Hold up. Here, let me put this motherfucker up here again. In every fucking state. playing with you and your children and your money and mothers. But yet you got the time to say you going to throw Dr. Ma'at's son out the motherfucking window, huh, bitch? You going to ride Dr. Umar's back at a wrong time when people persecuting him about bullshit. You're going to defame Minister Farrakhan and the dead brother Malcolm, Elijah, and dear brother Marcus. But look at you. In every motherfucking state, Pharaoh, KinderCare ain't even that motherfucking good, dog. Now, at this point, we ain't done. We gotta put the nails in this nigga's feet. Now, I wanna ask you at this point, the whole community, every large platform, every voice, every little voice, every woman that watched Sister Bria Cole get played like she's a Saturday night thot, a $2 whore, lied to and played, you dig it? Where are all the Negroes in the community hollering about scam, 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 scam? Because them whole ass niggas there was around to see this here. Roy Bates said he must be one of the kids himself. Yup, Roy. Him and Prince York. Him and Prince York. Prince York told us he was 17,000 motherfucking years old, family. Come to find out, this nigga 15. Rah. Y'all remember that nigga Prince York told us he was 19,000 motherfucking years old, family? This nigga here is goddamn older than Methuselah, he say. And our people just fall into that and they roll in that and waddle in that filthy bullshit. How many of y'all don't see that some crazy shit? A nigga come to you tell you I'm 17,000. Young Pharaoh got acne all over his motherfucking face. That might be syphilis or herpes simplex 10 or something, but there's bumps there that he can't get rid of. But he's teaching y'all about astral projecting. I told that nigga, man, let me catch you up in my motherfucking room tiptoeing around in this bitch, astral projecting over here. I'm gonna burn your goddamn spirit up, my nigga. Because you're a clown, bruh. Negroes like this would destroy everything black, powerful, and for black people. And what he got to offer us? No motherfucking education. This sister in here has a doctorate. And this silly son of a bitch gonna come tell the people, oh, she's not a real doctor. What the fuck is a doctorate degree, nigga? What the fuck is a doctorate degree? Do she have to be able to be the motherfucker to give you the herpes medicine that you and Seti taking on camera? Yeah, y'all remember that shit the other night, him and Seti. Seti talking about, I need some of that shit too. We know you do. Drinking herbs that's for herpes. Got y'all talking, man, I need me a bottle of that. But this sister got a doctorate degree. This silly motherfucker here in the community empowers him. Think about it. Everybody with common sense, put that shit on the scale. Dr. Ma'at and this clown ass nigga out of prison still motherfucking lying. $10,000, family. And I'm going to build a daycare in every state. Let's look at it one more time before we cut this nigga deeper. One more time. Look at lied to Bria. Lied to this poor ignorant brother talking about what you going to be teaching? Melanin sciences? God damn. That nigga said in every state. The definition of a nigga. Shout out to Sutet. Death to the Negro. Now watch this. We already showed y'all. Seti sleeping in the... Dr. Ma'at, did you see Seti sleep in the motherfucking bus station, sis? Did you see that? Black Wall Street. Facts. I got to show it to, hold on, y'all. Let me show Dr. Ma'at this shit. This is a general that attacks a real general. Minister Farrakhan, Honorable Elijah Muhammad. Been working for black people damn near 100 motherfucking years combined. Real generals. But look at this, Dr. Ma'at. You ever seen Seti like this here? This nigga is asleep in the bus station in North Carolina. I'm booked, bitch. I'm booked. My God. You look booked. My nigga, you look booked up. Hold up, my Dr. Mata got one more for you. Look at this one. Look at this. He a general, but ain't got no security. Niggas walking by him, taking pictures of him like he a motherfucking monkey at a circus or something. A circus monkey. Can you imagine the FOI or the NOI letting Minister Farrakhan fall asleep at the park or some shit like that? Can you fucking imagine that? It would never happen. Why? Because Farrakhan is a real general, a real ambassador. But this nigga here, sleep at the motherfucking wheel, family. Motherfuck. And I tell you, when I woke up this morning, no, it was last night, I fell asleep and I missed all the phone calls. Remember the brothers that I was talking to? If y'all watching, y'all know I ain't lying. I fell asleep and woke up to some good news. Where is Seti's channel, y'all? Have y'all seen Seti's channel today? I'm sweating a little bit because it's hot out here. Summer about to hit. But have y'all seen Seti's channel, family? Y'all remember Where in the World is Carmen Sandiego? Where in the fuck is Seti's channel? Oh, shit. No methodology, no sense. Sleep in the bus station. Your name is Seti and Pharaoh Allah. Double-minded than a motherfucker. Ain't that what the book of James say? Double-minded man, unstable in all his ways. This is your general, I said. Knock the fuck out at the bus station. I'm booked. But you ain't tell us this the way you booked, my nigga. We tried to ask Seti, bro, when you gonna tell Pharaoh to stop the bullshit? Seti gets worse than him. I wonder if Seti gonna chin check him on this one. Nope. Cause Seti heard me ask this fool ass nigga this shit when nobody else realized it a year and a half ago. He kept his mouth shut. But he called all y'all babies. His babies. Come on in, children. Are you grown? Calling people with doctorate degrees children. Boy, this nigga here, I tell you, the fentanyl epidemic is destroying our people. Fentanyl. Well, I need some lotion. But here, let's get this one out the way. Now, here's another one of his fans, right? Y'all can get the screenshot of this one, too. This is Xavier Shelton, family. He says, and all of you leaders, listen up, Negroes. Listen to me. Because when you paint yourself up as a wonder and you fall like Humpty Dumpty off the fucking fence and break and shatter into a million pieces like these two fool-ass niggas, know that it's not just you that broke and fell, but it's all of the people that was behind you. Seti, all the people you calling babies, grown niggas and shit. You call them babies, but you call Pharaoh a king. Young Pharaoh, this brother here says, Xavier Sheldon says, the conscious community, shameful shit. There's a lot of people in the conscious community. 80% of the conscious community are not shameful and are working on the behalf of black people. Imperfect and all, but still trying. Watch this one though. This is some real shit. Watch this. Young Pharaoh Allah done collected, and he put done collected approximately 60,000 from y'all with GoFundMe accounts. And I just pointed out 10. This brother says 60. With GoFundMe accounts promising y'all businesses, programs, etc. After all that, he has no services for you. What did I tell you in the beginning of this thing, family? These niggas want to destroy everything that we have, had, and will have. But when they step into place instead of what they chase out, ain't got shit to give. The sister said for like 2.0. God damn. Sis. Polite, watch this. At least polite giving refunds. If he did some bullshit, I can witness, you know what I'm saying? I'm not going to sit here and be like his lawyer, but I witnessed him give refunds on the air and shit. But this nigga here, I want to see how much of this 60,000 or just even my 10,000 that this little clown ass nigga is going to at least admit to, much less give back. Let's finish reading what this brother said. I like that though. That was a good comment. You something else. After all this, he has no services for you, this brother says. No businesses for you or programs. Listen to what he says about SETI. Sarah Sutton SETI, over the last 10 years, has collected about $75,000 in donations. These are y'all's fans, Pharaoh and SETI. They watching you. They see you. So the brother said over the last 10 years, SETI has collected over 75,000 in donations and still ain't got no businesses for you or programs either. Years of GoFundMe and ain't shit happening. Well, let's see. Years of GoFundMe and shit ain't nothing and nothing. Niggas have even, what do you say? Niggas don't even have a proper website, family. Man, SETI might have seen this comment because this was in March from a brother from out here in Westmont. This brother, SETI must have did that because he just come on the camera before they snatched the channel talking about he been to put up the website. You been on here for 10 motherfucking years and ain't gave people no website, nigga. No, a real good website. Would you offer something? 10 years. $75,000 you took from the people, at least. The brother here says, both these niggas, Pharaoh and SETI, display bad, disrespectful behavior on an extreme level. I promise the conscious community is gullible as fuck and love entertainers. Only who are habitual liars and frauds. Join that. The conscious community only loves entertainers, not alone, but who are habitual liars and frauds. Understand the brother's thought. He says, if you are a fraud, a habitual liar, yeah, that's where I'll trust, man, family. Lil Ralph Tresvant, aka Squeaky. Shout out to MBK, man. Yo, y'all gotta make sure you get that too, man. Back out, make sure you get the screenshot of the thumbnail. Tell me don't Pharaoh look like baby Tresvant, family. This nigga got, I'm telling you, he might be a stem cell clone, one of the first stem cell clones, man. That nigga look like Tresvant up and down. Shalom, Warfarin. Let me get this one in, family. the brother says, I promise the conscious community is gullible as fuck and love entertainers only who are habitual liars and frauds. If you don't have shit, you can become a conscious community celebrity and looked at as somebody putting in work. Hashtag sad. Hashtag fuck out of here. Hashtag Jim Jones Kool-Aid drinkers. And y'all need to look at that documentary. Because I heard a brother the other week talking about, and watch this, y'all gonna say, damn, Mike, what the fuck you talking about? But the Jim Jones. Y'all remember that shit? Jim Jones took all of those people down to Guyana and they didn't come back. If you listen to the Jim Jones death tape, which there is a tape recording and it persists to this day, you'll hear Jim Jones talking to these people, and they're mostly like 90% of the crowd ready to beat up and kill the people that didn't want to kill themselves that day. There was a lady on the mic saying, well, Jim Jones, can't we just call Russia since we can't get to Cuba? Because, you know, Jim Jones was dealing with the socialist movement, and plenty of people was dealing with the socialist movement, socialism back then. And so this nigga had his own sick version of socialism. And them people was into it. And this brother here is talking about the same thing. He might have heard the death tape. The majority of people that died in the People's Temple with Jim Jones were our motherfucking people. Drinking fucking cyanide. Giving it to their children. Because some son of a bitch told them to. Jim Jones acting like he's Christ. But on the goddamn tape, he don't have his teeth in. You could hear him sounding like this. And that. Pharaoh got acne. Jim Jones ain't had no motherfucking teeth. Said he's on fentanyl, raw fentanyl, falling asleep in the motherfucking bus station. Nigga pointing their fingers at sisters like Dr. Ma'at that got a doctorate degree. And this nigga here told y'all he want to build daycares in every state on parole. Let's go on and finish this one. Kool-Aid drinkers. The brother says, I've never had a GoFundMe and got more than both of them put together and better progress. If I did set up a GoFundMe for real business, niggas would ignore me. And I'm pretty sure you're true. You're right. Because that's what all of the teachers in the community are talking about. I even said it. And I don't ask people for donations and shit like that. I put my PayPal link out and I got like 20 people that give to me and they bless me. But why is that only 20 people when I done put my motherfucking life on the line for 4 fucking years for the community? I done exposed liars, cheaters, robbers, thieves, scammers, adjusted niggas here and there, body bags over here. Just showed you motherfucking shit about the FBI. I don't want to dog the dude out, but my nigga, real shit is real shit. We dug you up. And I'm saying, they will give young Dr. Ma, you see, Roy Bay, I need a man with sensitivity. Woo! God damn. Marshall Applewhite. Yo, man. Family, what we gonna do about this nigga? What the fuck are we gonna do about this nigga? These dudes destroy elders and all just with their mouth. This nigga said Malcolm was hanging up on the parents of the children that went to jail in the movement. Hanging up the phone on them. That nigga must have got that shit straight from the CIA files. Because I'm gonna be honest, they ain't even said that. Fuck. I gotta show y'all something else, man. Hold on, let me see if that do I have it here. Oh yeah, here it is. It's in my videos. I wanna show y'all this alien shit now. I'm gonna show y'all the other video later with him and many of y'all are seeing this shit, so you know I ain't lying. This Negro here must have been high off of MDMA or some shit. And the sad part is he got a woman in the room with him, and this poor sister is agreeing. I don't know if this nigga had a knife to her throat or what, but shit don't seem like nobody should be that stupid. They in the room, in his apartment, looking out the balcony at the interstate. The interstate. This nigga here telling the people on the camera that he just is 100% sure that the lights that are circling on that interstate and moving around and back and forth are UFOs. And the nigga even showed his face on the camera. And that poor young lady agreed with him. I don't know. Must be the MDMA. But I'm about to show you another, I'm about to show you that damn ghetto bird up there flying around, boy. Pharaoh, did you send that shit over my house, nigga? The fuck is wrong with you? You motherfuckers over my head, man. But here, I got to show y'all. You saw it, see? Eddie saw the video. This nigga world thought that shit was real UFOs, family. I want to show y'all this video. And shout out again to YK The Truth. I want to show you another aspect of his fascination with aliens, family. Now, let me set this up because I got to switch over my Bluetooth. Let me do that for 1 second. This is crazy. Crazy. This nigga here put his whole credibility on the line with this one. And still to this day, won't admit it. He was down bad for that shit. Out there bad, family. Watch this. Out there bad. Okay, here we go. Let's see. Let me cue it up to the right place.
It's another photo shot. It's another picture. All of this haploid right, that I wanted to show, and I couldn't get to the that I wanted to show.
I wanted to show. You stupid bastard! Look at this. Watch this, family. Let me turn it up.
Okay. It's another.
Hold on.
Picture. All right. Let's go.
I have over 50 different whatchamacallit, accredited artifacts from all over Africa, not just Egypt, but the specific picture I was looking for came from a hieroglyphic glyph in Egypt in the pyramid walls that I wanted to show, and I couldn't get to the picture. So what I did was I grabbed another picture of something that I was looking at, and I didn't spend as much time researching that as I should have.
Yes, we know.
Now, this is why I say young Pharaoh is a liar.
Look at that shit.
You gotta be a damn liar, because if you didn't spend enough time researching it, where the hell did you get all of this haploid group and they DNA tested the mummy and all of that? I'm gonna play the clip when he spoke about the haploid group. The haploid group. So that means that you lied. You made this shit up. You made it up. You were so desperate to prove I'm wrong, you lied to 3,000 plus people. I'm gonna play the clip for you. If you didn't research it thoroughly, where the fuck did you get the haploid group from that they tested it? And this is a fact. You telling people this is a fact. I'ma play the video for y'all. Okay? Here you go.
Now let me make sure y'all can see my screen, Sop. Hold on, let me drag these two out so that they're individual screens. We ain't making no mistakes.
Yeah,
now
right.
I'ma show you. Let me show you what you asked for And I'm going to show you an actual extraterrestrial mummy that was genetically tested, to have foreign DNA, and it was mummified. You see that? No. Let him laugh. Do more research.
Yeah,
see if it's factual. See if it's made up. See if they DNA tested it. And when it come back that they did, and when it come back that it has four haplogroups genetics to this planet, I don't want to see you on Cynetta no more. You asked me to show you the proof. I showed you the proof. You can laugh at it if you want, but this is factual artifact that they found.
It could have or could have not been a false picture. I'm not denying that fact. So the Aramai Pop, the Aramai Squad will score a point right there. I'm not jumped on the live stream, didn't bring my stuff because I didn't know I would be debating six mother
busted. And still, the videos that he make after. Well, I didn't. That's fucked up. You the disrespected. Listen, man. Who in the community haven't you disrespected? He wanted $4,000 from Cynetta for that fake ass attempted debate that he know they wasn't prepared for. All of this information come from this white guy. He done stole information. But won't sign a contract and somebody gonna give you $4,000 for somebody else's fucking information. Well, when I found that out, Ben, I almost passed out. Super pseudo. But family, when it rains, it pours, my niggas. Goddamn. When it rains, I said it pours, family. Now, I know this nigga's gonna be mad. And nigga, you threatened me before, I told you. I'm in California. You and Seti catching the bus out here all the time. So let me know when you out here if you don't like it. But I love you enough to come here and spank your ass like this in front of the Nation of Islam. Because I know there's about seven of those brothers watching. How do I know? Because I sent them the link. Mm-hmm. That's why I told you I'm going to tell Minister Farrakhan, bitch. I'm going to fucking tell, nigga. Yeah, the psychological structure of the pyramid. Family, I said these niggas will sell you, I mean, dust off the ground and tell you it's moon dust, like Joel Benjamin. Joel Benjamin, I call him the Wizard of Israel. This brother here will find some motherfucking rocks under in his shoe and tell you these are healing rocks. Nigga here got, he got invisible water. Water you drink it, you disappear and shit. Man, I swear, man. And we got all of these niggas that are full of shit, constantly pointing fingers at people that are imperfect, but are trying, man. How in the fuck are you gonna talk about Dr. Umar, nigga? And you this down bad. Like a motherfucking clucker. Always stealing. And then lying. Like a motherfucking clucker, family. These niggas need a fucking job, man. That's why this nigga was in jail. Because you ain't had no motherfucking job or no career or no craft. And you get right out. And you make sucking the fucking people dry your goddamn job. And but what you give, though. Google it, bitch. That's what you give. Now, in closing, y'all, know that it ain't over, because I told these niggas it's going to get way uglier than me showing y'all Seti sleep in the motherfucking bus station. Me showing y'all that this nigga done clipped the whole community for years. Clipped you so bad you done forgot about 10,000 at least of it. It gets worse. Just wait. And let me shout out a few people. Let's go into the chat. Like, share, and subscribe to New Black Knowledge. Warfarin Obey. Stone Soup TV. Black Wall Street. Eddie Thomas. George Macon. What's up, George? I didn't see you, man. Damn. Roy Bay. Brother Roy Bay, my brother, man. Let's see who else here. Dr. Oya Mayat. I honor you, sister. Thank you for showing you, coming here and gracing us with your presence here. I respect you, my sister. For real. If I skipped over somebody, just forgive me. Brothers Keeper, Ra Prophet, my motherfucking man right here. Man, 100 grand, dog. Fanta Root. Let's see who else is in here. Man, I love y'all. I love y'all and I appreciate y'all for coming here. And I encourage y'all, man, download this video. Take this motherfucker. Take this, bitch. Metaphysical books and beyond. Now, take this video, man. Y'all had this shit. I am Persec Mac. In the house, Black Power Sister. RBG Pharaoh, peace and Black Power to you, fam. J. Murray, 504. Crypto God. Mr. Lee. Yeah, man. And shout out to Mr. Me. Now, Pharaoh, Dr. Mod, it's my pleasure, sister. My pleasure. Real talk. Have to clean the house right away. Who is that? What'd you say? Me? Do I gotta clean the house? I'm gonna clean up the house of the conscious community. That's the house I'm gonna clean up. I'm going to sweep some of these devilish niggas right up out y'all community. And when you see them again, they're going to be looking like SETI, sleeping on that motherfucking bus in the terminal. But y'all, enjoy this one. And we're going to go out like this, fam. I love all y'all, man. Get this shit to Pharaoh.
What's up? Big fan. Y'all know how this shit go, you know. All eyes on me. Fuck oh, 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 yeah. Roll up in the club. All eyes on me. All eyes on me. You know what? I bet you got it twisted, you don't know who to trust. So many player-hating niggas tryna sound like us. Y'all say they ready for the bump, but I don't think they know it. Straight to the depths of hell is where them cowards going. Well, all your skill, damn nigga, holler when you see me. And let these devils be sorry for the day they finally freed me. I got a caravan of niggas every time we ride. Hitting motherfuckers up when we pass by. Until I die, live the life of a boss player. Cause even when I'm hot, fuck with me and divorce later. The future's in my eyes. Cause all I want is cash and things. I vibe double low, bands for me. Flashy ranks, bitches pursue me like a dream. Been known to disappear before your eyes, it's like a dope thing. It seems my main thing was to be made to pay the game sharper than the motherfucking razor blade. Save money, bring bitches, bitches bring lies. One nigga's getting jealous and motherfuckers die. Depend on me like the first and 15. They might hold me for a second, but before won't get me. We got four niggas and low riders and ski masks screaming thug like every time they pass. All eyes on me. To the life of a boss play. All eyes on me.
Peace and Black Power, family.
All eyes on me. To the life of a thug nigga. Till the day I die.